guys, and good morning. Today, I thought that we could have a little self-care Sunday together. This past week has been quite stressful and nerve-wracking with the elections coming up. So, you know, I thought that we could just de-stress and unwind together. Since I just showered, I thought that I would do a sheet mask because, you know, you can't have a self-care Sunday without a face mask. So the mask that I'll be using today is a new Press Refresh Hydrogel Exfoliating Sheet Mask from Zipstica, who I've partnered with for this video. Guys, this sheet mask is truly unlike any other sheet mask that I've tried. It's supposed to be an express at-home facial for acne-prone skin, and although I do not have acne-prone skin, I do struggle a lot with pores and uneven texture, and this mask really helps with that. This mask is drenched in exfoliating acids like salicylic, glycolic, and lactic acid, which all work together to unclog pores and refine uneven texture, and it also contains niacinamide and hyaluronic acid to help hydrate and soothe the skin. So I'm just going to put it on. I really like that it comes in two parts so it doesn't just like slip and slide all over your face. So I'm just going to apply the top part and then the bottom. Oh my god, I look kind of crazy, but because this mask is hydrogel, it's actually quite cooling. I feel like most girls look cute with face masks and they always take selfies with them, but that is just not me. And what's really cool about this mask is that it's infused with graphene that sinks with your body heat to work beneath the surface so that your skin is really able to absorb all of the ingredients and good stuff. So I'm just going to leave this on for 20 minutes and then I will be right back. Alright, time to take this off. Oh my god, so satisfying. My skin feels amazing. It's smooth and bouncy and ooh, look at that glow, and I don't even have anything on. So I'm just going to follow up with some toner. This is the Laneige Cream Skin Toner and Moisturizer, and I've been really liking this one. I feel like it's made my skin a lot softer since using it. And then for moisturizer, I'm going to be using the Believe True Cream Moisturizing Balm. So if you guys are interested in trying out Press Refresh, then I'll leave the link in the description, and you can also use my code ZOENAZOE to get 15% off. Today, I'm wearing this dress that I got from Jing, and I think that it's absolutely beautiful and elegant, but also comfortable, so I can just wear it when I'm lounging at home. Truly a win-win. I also got this adorable little PJ set, and I really love this olive green color. I know that for some people, they enjoy getting dressed in the morning, especially when they're working from home, but for me, I have always been a PJ gal. I love being comfortable, so it's nice having some cute loungewear so that I don't feel frumpy all of the time. And I know that things like skincare and clothes, they're all very surface level. They're not going to magically solve all of your problems, but I do think that on days when you are feeling a bit down, sometimes you just need those quick little pick-me-ups, whether it's taking care of your skin, painting your nails, doing your makeup, really just taking care of yourself in whatever way makes you feel good. Going to watch the newest episodes of Startup. Oh my god, if you guys haven't watched it already, go watch it. It is so good. It's just one of those feel-good kind of K-dramas. Skip. So I mentioned in one of my previous videos that I've been using my journal as my therapist. I haven't been journaling too much because of my wrist, but today, since it is the start of a new month, I did want to do like a little reflection. So this is the prompt that I will be using. I got this from Wellness with Steph on Instagram. Oh my god, I freaking love her. She is just everything that I wish to be. Her page exudes positivity, wellness, just like not giving a fuck about what other people think. So the first question is, what did I struggle with last month? What went well? How can I get closer to my goals this month? And then lastly, things to release and things to manifest. 2020 has just flown by. Like, I cannot believe that it's already November and we only have 2 months left of 2020. But honestly, it's all been like a blur because I didn't really do that much. So I'm hoping that by reflecting each month, it'll help my mind be less foggy, and it'll also help me to start practicing more gratitude because, you know, I do live a very good and privileged life, but sometimes it's easy to forget that when you're just focused on all of your problems. So yeah, here's to taking better care of our mental health. The weather is actually really nice today, so I think I might go on a little walk. But before I leave, I'm going to apply some sunscreen because it's super important to protect your skin, guys, especially if you're using acids on it. The one that I've been using lately is from Supergoop. This is the Unseen Sunscreen with SPF 40, and I really like this one because it's super weightless and invisible. It's also water and sweat resistant, so it was really nice using it in the summer. And I feel like it kind of acts like a primer because it like minimizes your pores, so I think that it would be a really good base for makeup if you were going to wear it. But since I'm just gonna be walking around my neighborhood, I'm not going to wear anything. And the finish is like velvety soft, so it's not greasy at all because I really hate greasy sunscreens. To see her. Oh my god, also I forgot how awkward it is filming in public.
Now that I don't have it, I only miss
So I realized I didn't really vlog too much in the city yesterday. I was mainly just trying to keep it a quick in and out because the COVID cases are rising. But yeah, it was really weird seeing the city so empty and boarded up. I don't think I've ever seen Herald Square so empty before. Yeah, it was kind of sad, but it did feel nice walking around in the city again. But as soon as I got home, I just showered and knocked out because I was so tired for some reason. I don't know, I feel like my body is definitely not used to going out anymore because I felt so drained and I didn't really even do that much. But yeah, I showered, ate dinner, and then the rest of the night was obviously very stressful and anxious. And then this morning, the same. I've literally just been tidying up the apartment, trying to distract myself and pass time. But I thought that I would show you guys what I got from Trader Joe's yesterday. Oh my god, it's been so long since I've been there. I missed that place very, very much. And I think everything that I got was plant-based or vegan. So yeah, I'm excited to show you guys what I got. Wow, I literally just took out all of my groceries from the fridge and freezer to film this mini haul for you guys because I am that extra bitch. So I got a few of my favorite coconut smoothies. I'm not sure if they changed them at all because they used to be pink, but I mean, I'm sure they still taste the same. I got a bunch of fresh produce, lots of fruit. Ooh, I'm also really excited to try this tempeh. I got this because some of you guys commented that I should try out tempeh on my vegan video, so I'm excited to try this. I wanted to try these Thai sweet chili veggie burgers because I think that they'll be pretty good to put on top of salads. Vegetable gyoza, I've heard pretty good things about these, and then I also got a few of the baked tofus, and I'm especially excited to try the sriracha one, of course. Some banana bread, and as you can see, I've already dug into it and can confirm this is so bomb, definitely recommend. And then of course, some mango mochis. I still have not found my green tea ice cream mochis, and I'm very sad because I do know that they are vegan. So yeah, I got two of these. Finally, I got these chili and lime tortilla chips, and they're basically supposed to be like a healthier version of Takis, which I love. I hope you guys enjoyed my little Trader Joe's haul, and now I have to put everything back in the fridge. I also quickly popped into Muji because I was looking for an organizer that was sold out online, and I was so thrilled to see that they had it in store. So this is just a clear acrylic organizer with 5 drawers, and then I also got some pens and then a pen holder. I am very stressed. We still do not know what the outcome is going to be. It is looking good for Biden, but you know, it's too soon to really tell. So yeah, it's just a waiting game, and I am basically just trying to eat my stress away as I did last night as well. I'm just having one of the vegan donuts that I got yesterday from Dough. I believe this is the hibiscus flavor. And you know, she's not looking her cutest right now because she's a day old and some of her icing came off, but I mean, it'll suffice. I'm just going to try to distract myself and start Record of Youth because I'm kind of on this like K-drama kick ever since watching Startup. I tend to go through phases with K-dramas, and plus I've heard pretty good things about it, so 구조할 수도 있습니다. 제발 빨리 가서 찾아주시기 바랍니다. 난 I've been craving donuts for so long. 사과. So good. 감사합니다. 어떤 모임? Another day, another donut. I'm just going to be editing today. Nothing too exciting. Kind of dry now, but I'm still gonna eat it. I got a new plant baby. I ordered this from The Sill, and I'm not gonna lie, she was pretty expensive, but I really like their pots, and I know that a lot of people in New York use The Sill, so I wanted to give it a try. I will say, I ordered this over a month ago, and I'm finally just getting it because apparently they lost my order in transit, and so I had to exchange for a different plant, but I mean, it's okay, accidents happen. So I got a little watering can, and then even though it took a while for this to arrive, I'm still pretty content overall. I mean, I wasn't really in a rush to get this plant, and I just think she is absolutely beautiful. Oh my gosh, look at all the different colors. Alright, so now I just need to find a new home for you. So one of my new quarantine goals is to grow some freaking eyebrows, because as you can tell, I am definitely not blessed in the eyebrow department. I've been using this Grande Lash Serum every night to my brows, and I know that this is technically meant for your eyelashes, but I've had this for so long, I'm pretty sure it's expired, but this was pretty expensive and I didn't want to just throw it out, so I've just been applying it to my brows, and you know, I haven't broken out yet, so I think it's okay. And I've been doing this for about a month and I feel like I've maybe started to grow brows. I'm not really sure. I haven't been too consistent with it. But yeah, I just wanted to share this and maybe we'll see an update. I just apply it like this and I try to focus on the inner part because I feel like that's where my brow is lacking the most.